Hello students, earlier we talked about asexual reproduction in animals and plants. Now we talk about vegetative propagation. This is a type of reproduction which is found in higher plants and in which a new plant is formed from any vegetative part of the plant. And the vegetative part of the plant, it may be like root, stem or leaves. And the question arises here, why such kind of reproduction occurs through any vegetative part? Because the vegetative part contain the meristematic tissues which have the capability of continuous division. So we can say that due to the meristematic tissues, the vegetative part develop into a new plant through this kind of reproduction. Vegetative parts like via root, the vegetative propagation occurs by root in sweet potato and dahlia. While with leaves or stem, such kind of propagation by stem occurs in potato, ginger. By leaves, it occurs in bryophyllum, adiantum, begonia, etc. There is some special point in vegetative propagation that it is plants produced by vegetative propagation takes less time to grow and bear flowers and fruits earlier than those produced from seeds. So from seeds means the reproduction, the sexual reproduction, in comparison to sexual reproduction, vegetative reproduction is more rapid and consume less time. The offspring produced by this vegetative reproduction is genetically identical to the plant. It means it is clone the parent, which is called as clone. Vegetative propagation is of following types. First is by cutting. The small fragment of stem which is used for formation of a new plant is called as cutting. It's a small fragment of plant which is called as cutting. And for this method, some points are in consideration. First is, some points are important for having such kind of vegetative propagation. And these points are A. That is, the age of mother plant should not exceed 5 years. Age of plant. B is, type of mother plant means the mother plant should be healthy. Type of mother plant. Again, C is, length and diameter of cutting. D is, proper season for cutting. The season of cutting should be raining, so proper season is also. These are the four points of consideration for having cutting kind of vegetative propagation. And for the fast multiplication of plants in cutting, some growth root sprouting hormones are also used, or we can say that root induced hormones are used, such as root hormones like IAA, indole acetic acid, NAA, naphthalene acetic acid, and IBA, indole butyric acid. These are the root induced hormone which can be used for the fast multiplication of plants. The lower part of the cutting in this method, the lower part of the cutting put into the soil of any one root induced hormone, and then after directly planted into the soil. Within the few days, adventitious roots are developed. From the underground part of the cutting, and new branches are formed on the aerial parts of the from the axillary bud of leaves. And such kind of reproduction occurs in, for example, rose, sugarcane, bougainvillea, etc. So this is all about cutting. Second is layering. Second kind of vegetative propagation is layering. This kind of reproduction occurs in dicots, and this method is used only in those plants which are having thin, long and flexible branches. In this method, adventitious roots induce artificially on stem when it is attached to the mother plant. Layering is again of two types. A is mound layering, or we can say another name of mound layering is ground layering. Mound or ground layering. In this kind of layering occurs in herbaceous plant, occur in herbaceous plants. The branches, these occurs in those plants with whose branches near the ground, branches near the ground, and due to this the part of branch must be, and before having ground layering it must be noted that the branch should be defoliated. Defoliated means removal of leaves from the stem. So part of the branch must be defoliated. After this, the branch bent down and cover with moist soil, and such structure called as layer. Branch bent down and cover with moist soil. This is called as layer. Now after a few days, we can see that the adventitious roots develop from underground part and branch detach. After few days, we see that adventitious roots are developed from the underground parts of the plant, and then branch detach from the mother plant. Branch detach from the mother plant. And this detached plant arises to new plant. So this is all about, I will show you all these steps by diagram. Suppose this is the ground part and this is the branches, this is the stem, and the branches should be bent like this. These are the branches which are near to the ground, and we should bury this branches under the ground. And after some time, you can see this, that the whole part is defoliated, which I told you earlier, that the part must be defoliated, means the removal of leaves. Defoliation, this is by clip, this is the clip, and after some time, few days, this is all covered with moist soil, and we can say that the adventitious roots are developed from the underground part. These. This is the adventitious roots. B part is, and the examples of mound layering is jasmine, strawberry, and raspberry. Air layering in this method. In this method, it occurs in higher plants like herbs and trees where stem cannot be bent to the ground, and the branch should be defoliated, as I told you earlier in the mound layering also, and remove bark in the form of ring or girdle. In air layering, we can remove the bark in the form of a ring or girdle. Girdle, and the entire part covered by the moist soil or cotton, which, and after putting the moist soil, we can wrap the polythene to preserve the moisture amount in the part, and the covered part of the branch, which is having now the moist soil as well as wrapped by polythene, to preserve the moisture, the whole covered part of the branch called as guti. Wrap polythene and the whole covered part called as guti. After some time we can see that adventitious roots developed and the branch cut, and it will give rise to a new plant. I will show you with this a diagram. That is, this is the stem here. From this part we can remove the bark from this part. This blue colored part, we can see that this is like girdle, and after some time we can put some amount of clay over it and then wrap it with polythene. This whole part, after some time we can see that adventitious roots grow from these part. This is guti. This is cover of polythene. This is all about air layering, and the examples of air layering are orange, pomegranate, lychee. These are the examples of layering. Third method is grafting. This is very interesting method to produce a new composite plant. In this method, two different parts of the plants are joined together in such a manner to grow as one plant. The most important thing of having grafting, it is only possible in those plants which having the vascular cambium. Only in those plants which possess the vascular cambium. Only in plants having vascular cambium. Cambium is the result of the secondary growth. So the plants should have the secondary growth, and before, after possessing this secondary growth, the cambium is produced, and the grafting is only possible in such plants. In this, two plants are taken like this. This is the ground. And here we use and another is this red color part, this shoot part, this red part, that this shoot part, and this is root supporting part. Shoot part called as scion and root supporting part called as stalk. Now what happens in this method? Two part of different plant. Different plant means scion is taken from another plant and stalk is taken from another plant, and these plants join together in such a way so that they grow as one plant. And this method is only possible in plant having vascular cambium, and successful propagation only possible in those species of the plants which are closely related. In this method, the root supporting part is taken from one plant which is called as stalk, and branch of the aerial part is taken from another plant which is called as scion. This stalk is always taken from wild species, means due to disease resistant power, and their root system is more efficient for absorption of water and minerals. But scion is always taken from the plant having better characters. Better character means the higher yield, like such characters are present in that plant from where the scion is taken. During this method, curds are marked. These are the curds. These V-shaped marked curds are marked on both of the part of the plant in such a way that it can form a connection between them, so that both of them properly fit together with each other. And now this joint is covered with the help of moist soil or thin layer of wax to check the loss of water and entry of pathogen. This is, for example, this is covered by polythene or a layer of wax to check the loss of water and entry of pathogen. This cut should be in shape of V, W or M, because these letters due to these cuts they connect from one another. Within few days we see that tissues of both of the plant mix together either by the activity of vascular cambium. In this way, a new composite plant arises. Vascular cambium is established between both of them and a new plant, and thus some adventitious roots arise from this plant, this part, and a new plant will be formed. From this grafting, a new composite plant arises. Means in that plant, both the better character as well as wild character of wild species both are present, having better from their parent plant. So this is new composite plant arise. Now what are the examples of grafting? That is citrus, rubber, rose, mangifera, that is mango. These are the plants resist grafting. What are the significance of having vegetative propagation significance? First is, by the use of vegetative propagation, it is used in such viable seeds are in those plants in which viable seeds are not formed or very few seeds are produced. For example, orange, pineapple and banana. Viable seeds are not produced. So in those plants, vegetative propagation are possible to those plants where viable seeds are not produced. Example, pineapple, banana, etc. Second significance, vegetative propagation helps to introduce plant in new areas. Introduce plants in new areas. Where the seed germination fails to produce mature plant due to change in environmental factors and soil. Third one is, it is more rapid, easier and cheap method of multiplication of plants. Fourth, by this method a good quality of race or variety can be preserved. Good quality. Because the offsprings are genetically identical to their parent. Can preserve. Last is, it is useful in horticulture also. Horticulture means the production of ornamental plants. Example, rose, tulip, etc. This is all about vegetative propagation. In next class, we talk about the sexual reproduction. Thank you.